And we're back with not Silent Hill Origins. I'm not feeling that one. As cool as that camera is, we're going to play something else. So let's see here. Make sure my volume's okay. Man, that's a quick turnaround for it to get back to that screen. I was liking that music, thank you. Alone in the dark. I mean, it's not Resident Evil, but okay. So, hopefully everybody's doing okay out there. This should look fine on y'all's end. I think I got all my filters looking pretty good. So this was one that I've always heard of growing up. Alone in the Dark is, I want to say it's older than Resident Evil and all that, but not this specific version. This is the new generation. This is like Alone in the Dark 4. Or the new Nightmare, whatever the fuck it's called. But it's very awkward. PS1 release, so we're going to be playing that version. Because I actually feel like the PS2 version is oddly too clean looking. It looks weird, and it controls very shitty. But to be fair, all versions of it don't control very well. Still got to use the D-pad, even though you got dual analog. Can't change that, because the analog left stick is your flashlight, from what I understand. So let's see what we can get into. In Massachusetts, October 30th, 2001. Of course. I don't know much about this one either, but it seems different enough. Like, I actually have been wanting to play it, so. Infograms, that's freaking nuts.
Condi, this is Fisk. I hope you had a safe trip.
I didn't.
I can already hear you ranting, but I've taken on a new case. I know, I promised I'd quit, but I was contacted by a man named Johnson to go to Shadow Island and investigate Obed Morton and the Apkanis writing tablets.
Oh.
Did that ring any bells? Now you understand why I couldn't say no and had to leave right away. I'm going tomorrow. I left some notes on the office desk. See you soon, Carmi. Oh, I nearly forgot. If you want to contact Johnson, he's at 555-1495.
Of course.
Boston Police Department. Name Fisk. First name Charles. Date of birth February 17th, 1944.
Okay.
So date of death October 24th, 2001.
This reminds me of The Shadow for some reason. Okay, Tim Burton much?
Somewhere in the United States, October 31st, 2001, 1800 hours, 43 minutes.
It's Halloween, boss. Got to get home quick.
So,
the fuck is this?
Shadow Island in about an hour.
Carnby's a loose cannon. But we had no real choice. And the professor?
Professor Eileen Sedrak is convinced that Obed Morton is her... We had no trouble persuading her.
I must have those tablets in their trap.
Dude's got no neck.
Is that clear, Johnson?
Perfectly, sir.
Fucker ain't got no face.
Sedrak? Eileen? Wake up.
What? Oh, sorry. Excuse me.
Here. You'll probably need this. Do you have your radio?
Yes, I have it.
Eileen. When we get to the island, for your safety, you'd better stay close to me.
My safety? Is there any danger? I was hired to authenticate the translation of the Apkanis stones. I will be working with Professor Morton.
My best friend died because of those tablets. He was killed on Shadow Island.
My God. Man, the voice is...
I'm gonna find whoever did it.
Look at the mouth animation on that dude.
I'm very sorry. Listen, I know Professor Morton's reputation. He's a scientist, a great researcher.
Just really weird looking.
Suspect.
We're getting close. Shadow Island.
hell was that?
The controls are dead.
Oh, Lord. Some Bermuda Triangle shit. Like, this intro reminds me of, like an Indiana Jones-esque kind of movie. Or something, you know? Ow. Shit. Okay, so we got Edward Carnby. I want to say he's the guy from the other games. 33, Private Eye. Characteristic, owns a double barrel gun. Okay, so I'm going to wait just a second because I know there's an add up just in case. Because I've only played like the first 5 minutes of this, and her characteristic is outright ridiculous. Aline Cedric, 27 years old. Professor. Characteristic, father unknown. That's her big deal. She doesn't know who her dad is. That's her characteristic, period. So, cool.
In the dark.
It's fucking stupid. I'm sure that plays somewhere into the story, but when it's like that, it's just silly. All right. So let's see here. You know, I actually do prefer this of the PS2 version. Go figure. I mean, like, it looks cool. I don't have the code. Okay, that was actually pretty cool. It's got a very, there's an evil thing going on, which is fine. I like fixed camera angles.
Carnby, answer me, please.
Aline, are you okay? I've got no idea.
Listen, I want out of here, right now.
Look, don't panic. I'll think of something. Where exactly are you?
On the roof of some kind of manor.
I'm over here.
I got myself killed. I'm really scared. Please do something.
I landed in some woods about 100 yards from the manor. Can you see me?
See you? How could I? Help me, for Christ's sake. Turn on your flashlight.
Okay, I see you too. Here's what we'll do. Try and get inside the manor, then find a place to hide. I'll come looking for you.
How long will that take?
I don't know. As little time as I can.
What?
Aline, I'll come for you, and that's a promise.
Hurry.
Yeah, see, the left stick is your flashlight. Which, honestly, like, this does not look bad for a PS1 game. Like, it's really not bad at all. What's up here? Nothing. My God. Oh, blood. Oh shit, my controller started vibrating.
Oh my god.
He's dead. Oh, or not. Oh shit, missing an arm for sure.
No, no, don't move.
Hey, bud.
Leave me be. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die.
Who did this to you?
This island is a hellhole.
Okay.
Not men. Filthy beasts. Flee. Get out of here any way you can.
How did you get here?
The boat. Last shipment. He shot everyone.
Look, just try to stay calm. You've got a gun. I'm leading you some bullets. I'll go and find help.
Don't leave him shit.
Help. But you'll die like everyone else.
Yeah, something about PS1 graphics.
I'll be back.
Anything around here? Don't look like it. Shit. This is actually pretty cool. This is already cooler than Silent Hill Origins. Is there anything in here?
God.
Oh, shit. Whatever it was tore his ass to bits. Oh, he had a key on him, though. Okay. Nothing? Not even the remains of his gun or anything? Locked. Okay, so let's see. Triangle? Okay. This is actually a neat looking menu. I like this. Oh my god, his gun. Okay, so it's a double-barreled revolver. Is what this dude fucking uses. Instead of a conventional handgun with a clip, it's a double... Look at this fucking thing. God damn. There we go. This music's pretty cool. Oh boy. Okay. Good lord. God damn. God damn, that was a bit much. Even for a 2001 PlayStation game, shit. Magnesium bullets. Music's all crazy. Like, this is pretty cinematic. This is pretty cool. Ooh. Okay, I think they ran away from something. That is an archaic ass looking first aid kit. That looked really cool. I mean, so far, this is pretty cool. This is already better than Silent Origins. Whoa! God damn. Damn, that fucker jumped. See anything else over here? This is cool. I don't feel compelled to run because I'm scared something's gonna jump at me. Shit. This music. Ah, shit. Damn. Statue is the height of bad taste. The hell's that? I just go in a big circle. I sure as hell did. Whoa. I mean, I think it's interesting. It's playing out pretty cool. I think it's rather cinematic. Music's really cool. Atmosphere is fantastic for a 2001 game. I can walk with my gun out. That's a big plus. Let's see what's over here first. Ooh, I like that. That's cool. I love little stuff like that. Oh shit. What the hell is that? Whoa. Excuse me? No. Well, there ain't that. I'm already dead. Cool. I want to know what it is about these damn games that I find, like, really cool aspects about them, and the second I start to like them, I die, and then, like, you gotta start over. There's always something that ruins something. They're not gonna start all over. That fucking sucks.
In the dark.
Gloucester, Massachusetts.
Hey, Leslie, what's up? Not a lot. We are playing Alone in the Dark. I literally just died, but like we're still at the very beginning, and now I gotta start all over again. And I'm now questioning, why is it that I'm always finding these games that they have like really cool things about them. How could I be okay? And then like something happens and it's like, well, fuck. I didn't have a chance to save.
At the moment, I've got no idea.
Listen, I want it right now.
Look, don't panic.
Because, you know, we're emulating. Come on.
Hurry.
There we go. Best part about emulating. So next time I'm going to save state. Speedrun conversation. No shit. It's like pressing fast forward. Hey, look. Blood. It's almost as if I've been at these stairs before. Let's go.
Beast. Get out of here if we can.
Okay.
The boat. Left you in a deep shot.
Just have to be calm. You're right down. I'll leave the boats. I'll
go on. But you'll die with everyone else.
It's almost like I've heard all this before.
Okay.
Alright, cool. Do this, get the key.
God.
All right, then we're leaving. Because it's one of those, it's like, I think it's cool, the game so far, but I'm going to have to save state because I don't want to be mad. you know, I don't want to rage quit and shit. I really just want to enjoy the game. Because there's definitely enough there, it's got me. It's already interesting to me. Okay, let's state it. All right, save state. Come on. Don't want to sit here. Just hauling ass, come on. Box of magnesium bullets, that's really weird. State that again. I wish I could get the analog to work. The stick. Son of a bitch. Goddamn zombie ass dog. Oh no. At least the combat shit's easy. And we had already run in circles. And this bastard got me. Not that bastard, but the next one. Screen. I think you can actually use the walkie-talkie.
Aline?
You have no idea. I forgot to tell you. I met an old woman. I believe she's Obed's mother. She seems half
Anything else?
I believe Obed Morton is on the island. But everything I've seen curdles my blood. It nearly drove me out of my mind.
Yeah, well, what else?
Is that your only reaction? Or maybe you want me to carry out the entire investigation for you?
Damn.
Don't act like that.
I'll react whichever way I want to. Over.
Man, this girl ain't taking any shit. How many of y'all will agree that the music is too fucking loud? So we saved. I really want to see what it takes to take one of these little fuckers down. Really, dude? That's gonna be a problem. All right. That was like, what, 9? Do you want to activate this valve? Yes. I mean, the cutscenes and shit are pretty cool. What do we got here? Oh, shit. Oh, boy. Oh, fun. What's my health at? Not very good is where it's at. Wait a minute. Charm of saving? What? So it's not a, like, there's no specific save points. It's a charm in my inventory. That is fucking weird. Wait a minute. It's gone. I just used it and it's gone. So saving is limited. Not so much in the fact of, like, ink ribbons. Yeah. Okay, so that's gonna be really weird. My gun loaded. I mean, I still don't hate the game. I still think it's pretty cool. Controller's vibrating. You don't know if that's interesting or annoying. Oh, I know. Because it's like... Whoa, what the fuck? This game is bizarre. Oh shit. Okay. So here's the thing, I don't understand like where I'm supposed to go. I assume it's the direction I'm going. I'm wondering if I have to kill this thing. I'm gonna laugh my ass off if this is two nights of games that we just don't continue. Okay. There we go. Really? Just put me at the top of the ladder. Okay, save state. I am not doing good. This is tough. This is tough, but it's better than Silent Hill Origins. You take a charm of saving. Okay. I would love a health pack. This is what we're going to do. Oh. There we go. Save state it right here. Like, I love the whole flashlight mechanic. Because, honestly, it looks pretty good. Ooh, health. A shotgun? A triple-barreled shotgun. This game is weird. Did you hear that? You heard it? Okay, well, that's all that matters. That thing holds 9 rounds. Let's open the casket. Of course I'm gonna open the casket. Are you kidding me?
No. Aline!
Oh, hey, a key. Gilded key.
Aline?
Oh, okay. All right, so where am I at? Map is interesting. This gate is locked. fish in the Boston University of Astronomy. Trap door is locked. Okay. Door is locked. I can't tell what that is though. It looks like kind of like a mining area. I guess I gotta go back. All right, I guess I'll go back because there was the like a staircase I didn't go up. I went a totally different route. No, let me check this door. Alright, let's see what we can do here. I feel a little better because I have a better gun. No? Okay. I mean, it's interesting so far. It's just really slow and stiff. I'm not hating it by any means. It's just, oh my god. Like, my left thumb hurts so fucking much because it's all D-pad. And like, you really gotta hammer the D-pad to make this game go. Nice. Maybe I needed to do that. That way I'd have a better gun to fight those things. Damn! This music is so edgy. I don't think it's a boss fight. The music's been like that half this game. No? Okay. Well, you know us here. We have no shame using guides. So let's see what we gotta do. First aid kit. We're on that. Flooded passages. Upstairs the basement. Left. Get the key. Use the key to open nearby gate. Okay, so apparently I was supposed to use that key. In case y'all are confused, I just did a load state, so that way I didn't have to run all the way back. okay. Because there's going to be a lot of this as we play. We're going to be doing a lot of reloading and whatnot. You know what? Friends, apparently I just suck at games. It didn't even dawn on me to try to fucking unlock that right there. All right. Was there anything else in here that I missed from before? Can't go up there yet. Okay. No.
Carnby, answer me.
I'm in a house.
Aline, I thought you were dead.
I did too. I'm not cut out for this kind of place. I want this to stop right now.
I understand.
You understand? You understand? You don't understand anything. I don't know what you, Johnson, or Professor Morton want of me, but I'm asking for this nightmare to stop right now.
Aline, get a grip on yourself. Where
are you? Oh, shit. You're being mean.
In some room. But I can't get to you. One of the doors is locked, and I can crack the other one, but there's some heavy object blocking it.
Okay.
I think it's Obed Morton who locked me in here, and I wanted to help him.
Don't move. I'll come free you.
Is that the best you can do?
Damn.
Yes, that's the best I can do.
Well, okay then.
Okay, hurry fine. Wow. She is, she's something else. Uh-oh. I'm so glad I have that shotgun now. That is so weird that saving is like linked to these things. An ordinary clock. Marvelous. Store is locked. Okay.
Aline, any more news?
I'm here waiting for you. What are you doing?
I can't find the room in which you say you're locked up.
It can't be that tough. I'm upstairs. There's a staircase in the lobby.
Okay, I'll head over there. Thanks.
Hurry up.
God damn.
I'm here waiting for...
I can't find the room in which you say you're locked up.
It can't be that...
Okay, I'll head over there. Thanks.
Okay, so I gotta go upstairs. I can't go anywhere else but upstairs. Look at that. I didn't even have to load the stairs. Wow. Okay, so there's something heavy in the way.
I think it's just a chest of drawers.
Well, then push it aside.
Okay, so far she's the best part of the game. Shit is hilarious. Hey!
At last. I want you to tell me what's going on.
I don't know yet.
Lady?
I do love your new outfit. Makes you look less...
you know...
Yes, I know.
Less what?
Here, I got your stuff.
Thanks. What about my jacket?
Whoever locked you up in here probably thought it matched his hair. Listen, I should never have agreed to let you come along.
I have my own reasons for being here. Were you able to talk with Obed Morton?
No. I don't either. No,
were you?
Yeah, Leslie, I don't know either. That was really weird.
So sure.
Like, I'm sure he's, like, hitting on her and shit, but, like, just the dialogue's just very awkward.
Way too dangerous. We have to find a safe place for you where you can hide and wait for me.
Listen, Carnby. You know as well as I do that the safest place is at least 2 hours away by plane. I haven't done too bad up till now, and I sure don't intend to spend whatever time I have left doing nothing. I want to know. Just before, I heard this voice above us. There's a trap door. If you help me, I can reach it.
Why not stick together?
You and I don't have the same goals. Remember what you told me in the plane. Come on, give me a hand.
What if I were to say no?
You're not the type to say no.
Know what that means. Possible ban evader. Of course it's a ban evader. Thank you, mod. Let's see here. Fuck is that? Acrobat statue? Oh, a little dude standing on his head, it looks like. Okay. And a dictaphone. Okay.
Ogulai Hypor Hanes Kona.
I have always wondered about the circle of stones located in the moors. When I would ask Edenshaw about it, he always remained very vague. I now think it's...
You know, the last time I watched the movie, somebody read something off a tape. Saw Big Message disappear. Yeah, it was like a huge it was like a bot or whatever.
Junction with the circle of stones. All this seems linked to the gate, to the opening of the gate, and to the ritual of the seven statues. Edenshaw was very surprised. It seems he had not thought them related. I therefore talked him into performing the ritual of his ancestors. I know his weakness and how to use it. He wanted to convince me of his powers as a witch doctor. Even he acted out of pride. I recorded him while he spoke the sacred words of his tribe. He was standing before one of the steels, and the direction in which he pronounced the incantation seemed an important part of the ritual. But nothing happened. The time has not yet come, is what he said, justifying him.
All right. Oh, it's a fucking door? I didn't even notice that was a door. Oh, wow. That's actually really cool for a PS1 game. Wasn't done with this room yet. An Indian posing in front of an underground door framed by two monumental statues. Hey. Oh, wow. All right. Time for some reading. January 13th, 1963. Today I am 10 years old and Mummy fell off her horse. She says she saw a big shadow jump up in front of her, which made Sultan rear up. Daddy made a doctor come from the mainland. He says Mummy won't ever walk or see anymore. I wonder what it's like to be blind. I try closing my eyes, but it isn't the same because I know I can open them again. Grandpa Jeremy made a new machine. It's not like all the other ones. It doesn't do much of anything, but it is very funny. You can make photographs that move with it. He told me again never to go near the gate. When I said that, Abed and I discovered it. When we were playing in the ruins of the fort, he got really angry. I know Grandpa Jeremy can open it up. Maybe someday he'll show me. January 21st, 1973. We went from... Yeah, I'm not done yet. 10 years. Okay. Grandpa Jeremy died this morning. Father's sorrow doesn't seem great. Grandpa Jeremy never told me how to open the gate. When I asked him, he told me that if my desire was true, then I would find a way. Father has forbidden us from going to the fort. He has even changed the combination of the lock to the gate on the bridge. If only he realized. Father is afraid of the creatures of darkness. I'm certain of it. He is a coward. He doesn't trust the weapons Grandpa Jeremy made. I wonder if these are all the weapons we're finding laying around, the weird ones and shit. He said we were going to leave the island and that it was time we started living a normal life. I think Mother agrees with him. I don't want to live anywhere but here. The world of men revolts me with all its triviality. Their preoccupations are so crude. Man is so vain. Grandpa left me a letter and half a photo of us in front of the gate. I can't even remember when he took it. There's a number written on the back, but I can't do anything with it. It's not the code of the library control of the board. Wow. It's not the code of the control board in the library. Why are they also afraid of the shadows of the night? I know one day I will learn to speak their language. I know that. One day I will pass into the world of darkness, and then nobody will be able to tell me what I can't or can't do, or what is good and what is evil. It's a 17-page... We're not reading all that. Wow, this is 2000. 14 through, blah, blah, blah. Do I see any numbers or codes? I do not. 17 pages. Kiss my ass. Oh, wow. You can actually see that it's, that's pretty cool. They definitely put a lot of effort into this. Okay, so where am I? Standing in this room? Yes. Green, that goes down. Let me see if I can open this one. Whoa! Door seems sealed up. Okay, that answers my question. Alright, we'll save state. And we're going down. Can't see shit down here. Where am I? Oh, hey. Door seems sealed up. Do you want to look through the spy hole? Sure. That looks all kinds of computery. This game is confusing. I mean, I guess I could leave this area and then explore that house area a bit, because it wasn't letting me do anything because I had to save her first. Maybe a scientist. He's carrying a curious object. It looks like an astronomical telescope. There seems to be a locking mechanism. There's a metallic plate, but it is blank. Okay. Oh, there's a blinky. Portrait is quite recent and exudes a strange melancholy. The character resembles a statue on the first floor. There seems to be a locking mechanism. There's a metallic plate, but it is blank. Okay. Surely an explorer. He's carrying objects, bandolier style, in the background, a ship. Is caught in the ice. There seems to be a locking mechanism. Let me guess. Metallic plate that is blank? Okay. Okay, I guess I'll check the last one. His fixed gaze and shivers down on the spine. On the table is a map of the island. Behind him is a strange statue. Seems to be a locking mechanism. Let me guess. Metallic plate. That's blank. Oh, that's a door. Door sealed up. This place sucks. This whole area is loaded. I don't have to do like stair loading and stuff like Resident Evil. Alright, bud. Marble bust flight reset. Mechanism at the base of the bust. Oh, well, I know this is HP because I saw a little thing earlier. Oh my god, I have to go through every letter? I don't have the code. Wait. Are you telling me that we can't Resident Evil like memorize things? Okay, so I gotta push this. Oh, well, there's your code. I thought it was HP. I need you to get in front of this thing. You can't even hold it. You have to press it. Everyone, you have to press. There we go. I would say, don't give me this I don't have the code bullshit. Okay. It's very annoying. Like, there's a lot of things about this game I like so far, but it's like, it's so stiff, and there's little shit like that that make it harder. Do you want to activate the purchase mechanism? Yes. You take the tiny rusty key. Okay, so we got that. All right. And yes, we are using a guide because ultimately I do want to enjoy this. Oh shit. How about your turn? You know what I would really love? Healing items.
I know who you are.
Just shoot his ass and get it over
with. I was expecting you.
Just stay where you are. Don't move an inch. Who are you?
They call me Edenshaw. I am the guardian of this island.
The guardian? Guardian of what? And what are all these monsters? What the
heck? He just said the island, asshole.
Professor Morton has definitely crossed the threshold.
Look, can't you spell it out? What is this mess?
My weakness is to blame. I let children play with powers way beyond their grasp. But the legends were not wrong. You have come to us. My only hope is that it is not too late.
This is all Greek to me.
It will become clear soon enough. Go to the library. The books withhold many a secret.
It's kind of how books work.
Take this charm. It will prevent you from falling into oblivion with all the others. Go, fulfill your destiny. Save us.
You got any fucking health packs on you, bud?
I didn't come here to fool around. I came to investigate Fisk's death.
I do not know who you are talking about.
Charles Fisk. 50-ish, about 6'1", graying hair.
I still do not know who that is. You see, nobody's come to Shadow Island for months now.
Okay, that's about enough of this. Oh, God.
I'm tired of you not giving me information to shit that has nothing to do with you. That happened before I got here. All right. Better save it. Because I'll be damned. Yay. A what? Disfigured statue. Okay. We're gonna have like double saves. We're gonna have save states, and we're gonna have the saving charms. Carrot came there. The fuck was that? Uh-oh. Whoa. Sure. Shit. That was crazy looking. Okay, so that awesome soundtrack kicks in whenever you got to fight. The hell am I? This map kind of sucks. Okay, I came in through here, right? Saw him on the floor. Full. display cabinet with the ship model in some kind of balance. Oh, shit. The fuck? You take a photograph. Sure. How's this? You take a wolf mask. What the fuck? That's so weird. They're not even there and it just jumps you. But I add, I have not seen a health pack in forever. What the fuck? That's annoying. Okay. Oh, hey, what do you know? Yay. Yeah, it's been how long? Like a solid 45 minutes, right? And I haven't had a health pack? Which is fucking crazy when you think about it. Even Silent Hill gives you a lot of health. Damn. Where the hell high up does this go? Oh, I see something. Oh, nice. Grenade launcher, because why the hell not? You know what that noise is.
In the attic.
I went through there. I saw that there's some sort of trap door on the floor. You'll see it. When you walk on it, it has a hollow sound. I met Edenshaw, the old Indian. He told me he was the last witch doctor. He says he can do something that will stop all this madness. Do you think we can trust him?
I met him too. He seemed to know a lot more than he said. But I don't think we have much of a choice anyhow.
He needs seven statues to carry out some sort of ritual.
Well, why doesn't he go looking for them?
Can't we help him?
Sure.
Why?
What do these statues look like?
I don't really know. They depict some kind of animals, I think.
Oh, well, that narrows it down.
Well, I got one.
Carnby, I'm sure it's really important.
I know, I know. We'll find his statues for him. But after that, we're going home.
And where is your home?
I don't know yet.
We'll get to that later.
Open so edgy. Up. All right, before we continue, I would like to try something. But the controls here. I'm going to try to remap my movement. Oh my god. It worked. Kind of. Oh, that's so much more comfortable. Don't you say there's a trap door up here? Oh, there it is. It's up top. Nice. See, this is what it should be. I was able to remap my left stick. So the left stick is now walk. And the right stick is my flashlight. That actually feels so much better. See, that's actually pretty smooth too. Yeah, now it's actually comfortable. It doesn't feel, my thumb's not hurting because the D-pad. Uh-oh. Oh, wow. Wow, his walk back is a terrible admission. I don't want to use a... my shotgun, but I mean, what's the fucking point? Yep. There we go. How the hell am I? Shit. That one didn't even warn you. Thank you. Ah, shit. There we go. Hey, random ass crowbar. Why not? Ten pages? Man. This game ain't playing when it comes to the story and shit like that. This is crazy. Tell you what. Thank you, mod. Ooh, fancy graphics here. You know what? We'll take a picture of this for next time. I have a feeling we'll keep playing this. But I'll definitely break it up. Okay, so guess I gotta read it now. Everybody, hold on to your ass. We're gonna read 10 pages worth of fucking terrible shit. Shadow Island, April 12th, 1905. I, the undersigned, Richard Morton, being sound of mind and body, declare this document to be my will and testament, my last will and testament. Let no other take its place. Archibald, my son, the mission I undertook many long years ago is still vast and incomplete. I expect you and your descendants to strive without respite for its completion. To this end, I bequeath you my goods and chattels, I believe. I've never seen that word before. My estate and all it contains. Let De Corzo guide you. He will tell you what to do and how to do it. Archibald, I have often seen doubt cloud your youthful eye. Sometimes your glance betrays your disapproval. Indeed, I have sacrificed human life, but name me the conquest without sacrifice. Indeed, I have defiled almost every commandment in the Bible, but isn't mortality always the first casualty of progress? What worth do a few miserable lives have to compare to the immense discoveries, the enormous unprecedented advances that I have made? Archibald, I know you are no coward. I know that with De Certo's help, you will go far, much farther than I ever did. You will be the one to venture into the unknown. You will set the foundations for a new humanity. I know that because of us, the Morton name will shine with the light of 1,000 stars in the great pantheon of history. My detractors will become the laughingstock of generations to come. Thanks to you and the confidence I have in De Certo, our destiny shall be fulfilled. Thus do I leave this world in peace. My library is my life's work. I wanted it to be a hexagon, the perfect form of 6 equilateral triangles representing the universe. It is a repository for 10 centuries of human knowledge, worthless every word of it. 10 centuries of empty hollow treaties, 10 black centuries of ignorance, vain and stupid reflections that remind us each day how vile and petty the human spirit is and how boring this fucking document is. 10 centuries and not one mention of the world of darkness. I understand now that humanity has let its destiny go by. However, 4 works are worth saving. 4 works contain the true key. I have discovered a symbol that represents the worlds of darkness and of light. 2 entities in equilibrium, one above the other. The one does not exist without the other. 2 triangles juxtapose in opposition. The one clear, the other dark. I place the 4 books vertically in the space in the library representing the symbol. The symbol thus crosses the library from one side to the other. The first is placed the highest, the second the opposite. Light, darkness, darkness, light. Sure. I can't believe this game has 10-page documents in it. That's pretty crazy. You take the flask. A painting of a shaman cast in an incantation. A luminous sphere floats in front of him. Okay. You take first aid. His cupboard is empty. Okay, so let me, I'm going to clear this room here. And then we'll probably go ahead and call it. Okay, so let's do this. We're going to... Whoa. Wonder why you're walking on your own. Stop it. Alright, save that there. And of course, we'll have our backup saves. All right, cool. All right, everybody. Well, thanks for hanging out. Appreciate it. Game's definitely interesting. It's got enough different things in it, and it plays differently enough that I'm willing to keep going. So we will see how things go. Wednesday and Friday, or just going through the week, we'll just see how things go. I would like to probably get in some Exoprimal. We haven't done that in a while, so we'll probably do that sometime this week. Yeah, this game's really weird. It's so stiff. I can't describe how stiff it is. If you've played the old school Resident Evils, it's stiffer than that. Like, it feels like you have to damn near mash the button to make it move. It's really odd. But I mean, I guess that's just the way this game is. I definitely see the potential. I see what they were doing. It blatantly rips off everything like everything else does. But I mean, it's still pretty cool. It's a little different. It kind of feels like a 70s horror adventure flick, kind of. It's kind of like Indiana Jones meets like Evil Dead, but not nearly as good. That's the best way I can describe it. So, all right, everybody. Well, take it easy. Have a good one. I hope everybody has a good night, and I will see y'all next time. Later.